Does racism still prevalent in Japan, even in this day and age? Sorry, this is 2 years ago, but according to the ranking I've checked, Japan is quite behind from many European countries, even below a country like Russia or South Africa. Another survey saying more than 30% facing discrimination, giving us examples like housing discrimination or racial profiling by the police. I've got a lot of questions about it, so I'm gonna ask people in Japan about that, both foreigners and Japanese. Sorry if your question was not included, but maybe in the next one, and I hope you'll get some sort of idea how we see racism today.
The gaijin space, right? They call it the gaijin space. I've never actually seen it happen in person, but I have noticed that some of my American friends and Canadian friends, when they come here, they do get looked at a lot.
たまにあるね。たまに。向こうはないから、すごく難しいね。
難しい。
難しい。
For average people who have like, you know, who lived here the whole time, you know, doesn't have that much international experience. Not scary, but, you know, I think the first thing they'll do is try to avoid them. You know, keep distance so they don't have to interact with them. Maybe not a necessary racism.
Yeah, でもあれは差別じゃなくて、単純になんかこう離れてるだけみたいな感じあると思うんですけどね。その嫌やから離れるとかじゃなくて、はい。
I don't know if other people have experienced this, but I experienced this my first year living in Japan. I was so inconfident because people kept looking at me. I could feel people staring at me.A lot, which had never happened to me before in my life. I didn't want to go buy food for myself.
ただその海外の方はマスクはされてたんですかね。結構ね、白人の方とかあのワクチン打ってたらこう、でも日本人って結構もう元からマスクをする習慣が結構ある人種なんで、海外の人を毛嫌いするとかそういうのじゃなくて、割と海外の方マスクされてなくて歩いてはる人多いですよね。
マスク or no mask?People tend to keep distance from foreigners anyway.
Sometimes I'll get on the train and sit next to like a small like obasan, kind of small old lady, and she'll just get up and move. I'm not sure if it's because I'm just a foreigner or she's afraid I will just suddenly speak English to her or something. But I try to just, I don't care.
Just go to the grocery store and, you know, everyone...stares at you, turns their head, you know, kids will like tug on their mom, be like, look, it can get really exhausting living with that every day.
The fact that Japanese people who have mostly never met a black person, who have never talked to a black person, probably couldn't talk to a black person, even if one were there in front of them, it's not really surprising that people might have a little bit of fear or preconceived notions.I don't think it's a good thing, but I think it's kind of a natural thing.
そんなのは俺たちが外国に行ってもいくらでもありますよ。アメリカとかって結構自由そうな感じだけれど、近寄らないやつは話しかけないやつとか、話しかけても来るなみたいになるやつがっていっぱいいるんですよ。田舎とかって言うと特に。
例えば電車に乗って、まあ、距離感をなんか取る日本人とかジロジロ見つめられることは個人的には問題ないんですよ、私的には。それも差別って言っちゃう人大げさなんじゃないかなってちょっと思うんですよね。
Like, oh, like not sitting next to me. Like, I thought it would happen. Like, when I was in the train, I was like, oh, I wonder if people are gonna avoid sitting next to me. And sometimes they didn't, but、I wasn't sure whether that was because it was me. Maybe it was. Who knows? Maybe they were uncomfortable sitting next to a foreigner. But、I was really lucky not to experience anything outright. Maybe stares, yes, every now and then.But I don't stand out that much from a Japanese person. Like, I'm relatively the same height. I don't seem like a threat to other people, and so.
あんまり見た目がちょっと日本人と似てるんで、外国人の扱いされたり、そういう悪い経験をしたことはない。
じゃあ日本人全部私たちのこと嫌いなんだなと思ったりするんですけど、実、リアル生活の中で実はそういう態度で接してくる日本の方ほとんどいない。
ヨーロッパの友達とかアメリカの友達に会ってみると結構日本人の友達を作るのがちょっと難しいっていう話をよく聞きますね。
In Japan, like, since we are an island country and we only have a Japanese people, so there's not much of a racism.
いや、そんなないと思いますけど。
ないですか？
だってあったら来てないでしょ。って感じですね。 I think, of course, at the end of the day, there is racism everywhere, but I've heard a lot of Japanese people say there's no racism in Japan.
Yeah, ないですね。
あ、ないですか？
ないです。人種で決めるんじゃなしに、人と人は会って喋って初めて分かり合える。
見えづらいんですよね、人種差別の被害って。自分たちと異なる人種の人たちの境遇を目にする機会がほぼないんですよね。
私は特に中国人だから、差別を受けたことはない気がします。ただ、私、アルバイトしてるお店で、中国のお客様来るんですけど、その、日本人の店員さんはやっぱ、日本人のお客様はすごい丁寧に接するんですけど、中国のお客さんになるとちょっと荒い対応に。
自分と同じ人種の子は一人もいないし、人種っていうかもう、ハーフとかミックスの子は一人もいなくて、その時は、三人の男の子に髪を引っ張って引きずられたりとか、結構、ちょっとすごいいじめられてました。なんか、みんなとルックスが違うとか、髪の毛が違う、肌の色が違うで、すごいピックされてました。
I used to live in Kansas, which is middle of nowhere. Being treated like I'm never going to be the same as them. I think most of, harsh words came out of ignorance rather than deliberate intention to hurt me. But I know I was hurt. And so I can relate to the Hafu kids that being treated different, being deemed that you're never going to be, you know, the same as them, one of them. Japanese people, they need to learn as an information, not just as an information, but also experience at early age what it feels to be different.
私は正直見た目による差別をあんまり受けたことないんですけど、ただ自分が親と一緒に、その自分の母親、特に母親なんですけど、こう私に対しての対応と母親に対しての対応が、今はあんまそこまでないんですけど、昔は本当に感じて、例えば、こう買い物行った時とかに店員さんがやたらと私の母親を遠くから監視してる。まあなんか盗むんじゃないかって思われてる。そういう、なんだろう、こう見た目による判断っていうのはすごく多いなと。
When I was 12, my dad got transferred back to Japan. I joined a local school in Japan. I wasn't excluded, but I think people were taught to, you know, talk to the international kids and like make them feel included. So that's why I was never bullied, but I felt inside that I wasn't the same as the other kids because, you know, I like communicated differently, I thought differently, and I didn't feel a connection with anyone.
話しかけることは難しいと思います。みんなは信じられないか、なんかちょっと嫌なことか、そう。
Some Japanese people found it like menbukusai, like having to deal with a foreigner. Like they would just see me and just be like, oh, like employees especially. They just feel like, oh, I have to deal with this, you know?
多様性とかダイバーシティとか多文化共生とかいろいろやってると思うんですけど、知識としてあっても、こう経験、いきなりこうバッて、なんだろう、いろんな国の人が目にするようになって、それに対応しきれてない。
Racism exists in the US too. But I feel like people are a little bit more, open to different ideas and different cultures over there. Japan, it's kind of like a homogenous country, you know, it's mainly Japanese. Yeah, I feel like there's a little bit of like, fear, I guess, of the unknown from like other, like people from, you know, other parts of the world.
でもまあそういうのは基本的にどこの国でも認めてないじゃないですか今国際的な評価みたいな話だけじゃなくて本当にこの国はそれでいいのかって中からもう話として出ると思うんですよ
To be honest, since I blend in, I don't really encounter any discrimination
Yes and no, because I look Japanese, but I feel just like the way that I dress, the way that I walk, people could tell that I'm not from here.
I'm not sure about fitting in, but when my mask goes up like this, a lot of people here just assume that I'm Japanese. I have the black hair, I have the eyes. So yeah, I blend in like that.
If you go to a store or something and you speak in Japanese, just because you look foreigner, people will become deaf and just can't listen to you and they're just very apprehensive at the fact that you're a foreigner and they don't speak English, so they don't really know how to react. Stuff like that, but nothing aggressive.
Many, many times, I have been minorly discriminated against. When I speak Japanese, people often don't listen to me. It's not that they can't understand me, they just don't listen to me. And they can't get past my face.
The reactions are just like crazy. I feel like people just don't even believe it, that they just like decide that I'm half Japanese or something like that.
I think that's too bad, but I don't think of that as a kind of act of discrimination. I don't think they hate me or anything like that. They're just so surprised that I speak Japanese.
Judging someone on the color of their skin, you know, that's their problem. But for me, I just don't care. But nobody like ever said anything, or I never had any problem, or yeah, I think overall it was fine.
If we compare with all the different race or like color of skin that can be in Japan, I think white people are, we're the most like accepted, like out of all like black people, or even like from people from India or Philippines, stuff like this. White people, we're actually quite okay. Of course, they have stereotype. Of course, we stand out. They see you as a foreigner, so they always speak English to you. They're always sure that you don't speak Japanese and you don't understand like the culture. But mostly, we're quite okay. So what happened is mostly it's like the racism we have is mostly positive. They always treat you differently, but they always accept, for example, the mistake you make or those kind of stuff. I would feel, yeah.
In some places, like public baths, I didn't feel as welcome there. I just felt like people didn't really want me there. People just are a little bit shocked, or they don't expect to see a foreigner in a public bath. Maybe I did something wrong, but I didn't really like dry myself off. So the locker area got pretty wet on the floor. I noticed this lady was like looking at me a lot, and I didn't really know why. She basically ran over to an employee, like tapped him on the shoulder. 2 minutes later, the employee comes back and starts wiping like that entire water area between us. Like, what's going on? And then she was talking to the employee and she was like, and I was like, oh, she's talking about me. I just felt like a little bit upset because it felt passive aggressive. And I just like briefly apologized, but she didn't really acknowledge me. But yeah, like that was like an little experience where I was like
まあでもそういう経験もありましたけど、そんなずっと高校までね嫌な経験をしたわけじゃなくて、そのすごい小さい頃にそういうちょっと嫌なことがあったぐらいなんで、逆にすごいラッキーな方なんじゃないかなと思います。
Because I don't look Asian, I can't blend in. I feel like if I was like a black person or a Hispanic person, I would feel the same way.
So how about you? Would you move to Japan?
I wouldn't mind at all, actually. Even though I was different or I was a minority, I didn't have much of a problem because what I kind of prepared myself was that I would adopt the mannerisms as much as possible or try to kind of assimilate as much as possible. For me, in the future, I wouldn't mind living there because I'm a person who, like, it's easy for me to adapt. Just have a positive view going there as well. And I think because of that, I've had one of the best experiences I've ever had. So.
Ah, よかった。I was actually quite worrying about you because I was told that by African American, you know, Japan is quite racist, especially against people with dark skin. What do you think?
I think that idea that is being promoted in America that black people are just this oppressed group that everyone hates. I think when you're constantly reinforced with that belief system, you think that it happens everywhere else, especially Japan. But I also think it's also because a big problem with blacks is that we are too emotional. And I think when you're too emotional, people don't want to engage with you because they're afraid of you're calling them racist or, you know, that you're a hater, a bigot or whatever. So you tend to find that they attack with a lot of emotion. So.
なんか難しいですよね。なんか私がドバイにいた時に、これをやる人がいて、これやる人、差別でやってる人もいるけど、そうじゃない人がいるって知って、別に差別と思ってやってない人もいるって知って、いい気はしないですけど、別にだからといって差別とは起こらない。なんかそれもなんか、なんか、どうなんだろうなって思いますね。
People's concept of what is racist?It really depends on the person. When I grew up, or I should say, when and where I grew up, the words racist and ignorant were almost interchangeable. If you don't know something about somebody from a different race, that could be considered racist. And I think that there are many, many people who would consider that racist. But that's not slavery. That's not hanging people. Kids in particular, people are just really curious. If you've never seen somebody who looks a certain way, you're probably going to want to ask questions about them.You might not trust them.
されたやつの取り方やね。されたら、差別されてると思ったら差別だし、それかもかっこいいから特別扱いされてる。それ本人の捉え方でしょ。
And I'm the first person with skin this dark that they've ever had a chance to meet and touch. I'm the first person, oh, you probably can't see it today, but because I keep my hair really short these days, but my hair is really curly. Yeah, little kids come up and touch my hair and say, like, it feels like a sheep, or I feel like a dog, or something like that. And you know what? Yeah, maybe a little bit. But for the most part, when I'm friendly to those kids about it, they do not care. If they're like, oh, your skin looks really dirty, and they're like, yeah, but check it out, it's not dirty. They're like, wow, amazing.
俺は全然何も、はい、ないです、ないです。だから逆に外国の人の方が黄色人種だの、イエローモンキーだのとか、向こうの人の方がなんか日本人を毛嫌いしてたりとか、こっちがどうこうっていう前に外国の人の方が日本人を下に見てたりとか。
I think some Korean people and Chinese people, they blend in. But I have a Korean friend who, she speaks Japanese fluently, and when she makes reservations at restaurants, everything is fine until they ask her name. And when they hear her name, then they say, oh no, you can't come in.
まあ今は K-POP とかドラマの影響があるから、ポジティブな方向で見てくれる方が多いですがね、最近は。友達の中で対日の方も結構いらっしゃるんですけれども、対日コリアンに対する印象もちょっと良くなったよって言ってくれたりするんですよね。
あ、髪だ。
こんなに気にすしていませんでしたね、きっと。すみません、なんか自分は、そんななんか、芸能人とかじゃなくて、一般人だからなおさら気にしてるだけで、そうそうそう、すいません。
いやいや、それはわかります。皆さん気になりますよね。
私も日本に長いので、途中で数年くらいは、本気で日本出ようと思ってたんですよね。もちろんその外国人としては、いや、私は外国人だから知らない、日本の空気なんて読めないっていうふうに思うこともできるんですけど、白人じゃないから、いわゆる外国人の見た目してないじゃないですか、日本人からすると。そうすると、いわゆる外国人、西洋人も白人みたいな人だったら許せることでも、こういうアジア系の外国人は多分許されないんだろうなっていう思う気持ちはあるんですよね。で、僕日本文化知りませんっていうことはなかなか言えないので、本当に日本文化理解して日本人らしくしないと、そこは、それはそれでなんかダメなのかなっていうふうにプレッシャーはあるので、数年くらいは本気でそれはもう息苦しく感じてて、至って普通の日本人に見える時が多いので、日本人らしく行動しないとっていうのはありましたね。
Younger generation, I don't think they really care. But from the older generation, I think it's more often they still have that mindset that Japan's closed. They want to keep it homogenous instead of starting to diversify more like America or Canada.
割と普通の目できちんと見てるとは思うんですけど。
あ、そうですか。
ただね、私、英語はできないんで、私できない側で、日本語しか。
そんな、で、今はもう、ほとんどいないですね。うん。はい、いらっしゃい。大丈夫です。
中国の方とかの印象って、やっぱ、なんていうんですかね、食べ残し多いとか、そういうのがめちゃめちゃ印象が強かったんで、まあ、そこはまあ、文化の違いあるんで、なんともしょうがないですけど。
ちょっと前やったらね、中国の方やったら、もう、病原菌のなんやかんやで、やっぱそういうね、離れるっていうのはありましたけど。
その、実感してるのが、やっぱりネット上の情報、辛口とか、あと中国は悪い国とか。
差別的な発言をする人は、やっぱ一定数いるのかなとは思ってます。僕が多分一番言われて、嫌だったのが、お前には侵略の血が入ってるんだ、みたいな。ステレオタイプな方って、まあ若者というよりかは、どちらかというとその、年配の方が、昔の中国に対する、その、古いイメージを持ってたりしていて、ただ、大多数ではないと思います、全然。まあもちろんその、もしかしたら、心の中で思ってる方はいらっしゃるかもしれないですけど、まあ、日本人ってそういう国民性じゃないと思うんですっていて、やっぱそこをわざわざ表に立って口にする人って僕は少ないと思うので。
やっぱり世代によって経験するものがある。違うんじゃないかなって思って、40、50代の方は結構辛い思いをしたっていう方も多いし、今の20代の若い在日コリアの方と話してみると、全くそういうのはないって方も多いし、世代によって違いますかね。
私もその不動産に関しては、
ちょっとよくわからなくて、不動産にとって何が不都合なのかはちょっと私もわからないんですけど、でもそういう話は結構聞いたことあります。
まあ言語が通じない、ちょっと偽名使ったりしてはる人もいましたね。
人種差別という、そこの点に関しては人種差別というよりは行動だとは思うんですね。例えば人を集めてパーティーをして大きい音を出す、ゴミ出しのマナーというか分別であったりとか、そういうところで結構近隣の方と、まあ、実際そういう方が多いなんですかね、問題が起きてるとか、そういったところが、まあ、それもだから結局実績だと思うんですけれども、まあ大家さんであればそれに対しての苦情の対処をしたくないから、だから外国人だからという差別ではなく、多分その方たちの行動。
I think we have to go back to basic things. Being good to our neighbor, you know, communicating with people, because people need to see. It may not change the every single person, but I think the basic things of just, you know, showing versus telling, so that people can get a new image.
Like real estate people, that maybe they'll have more like regulation, more paperwork. Plus, you know, if they don't speak Japanese really well, or, you know, that's like another language barrier that they had to, you know, find a translator. It's not a necessary racism, you know. It's just like it's more work that they'll try to like avoid them not to work.
まあ不動産屋も商売なんで、だからといって放置していてもいいのかっていうのはまた別の話になってくるし、そういう人が外国人なんだっていう決めつけで、外国人はみんなそうだみたいな、外国人でくくっちゃうとダメだと思うんですよ。
Even rent, not even buying, just renting a house was quite difficult, even though my passport was Japanese, because the reply I got was, oh, but you weren't brought up here, or, oh, but your father is not Japanese. So I guess having a passport is not really important.
全く日本語にも支障がなくて、というか、まあ、第一言語が日本語なのに、日本で育ってるのに借りにくいっていうのは、なんか考えさせられます。
People just not getting a house or an apartment in Japan because they're simply foreigners, just based on how they look. And in the US, like, you know, it's illegal to deny anything to anyone based on their race or ethnicity, whatever it is. And so it's a little bit frustrating just to feel like I have to follow those rules.
A lot of people think I'm rich. Before they meet me or anything, they just assume I have a lot of money because I'm white. When I applied for an apartment here in Tokyo, afterwards, the real estate agent, she told me if I wasn't white, I wouldn't have gotten the apartment. There's still privilege even though I'm a minority, which is kind of crazy.
確かにそうですね。留学生もそうです。結構職質されたって聞きます。特にアジア人って、まあ、見た目が日本人かどうかわからないパターンも多いと思うんですけど、やっぱ結構な確率で職質。
危ないって聞いてる街だったりしたら、やっぱみんな身構えするじゃないですか。警察の人も頻繁に見回ってるんですよね。なんでかって言ったら、警察の人は何をしてるのかっていうのを逆に安全を見回ってるんだけど、職務質問しかやり方がないからだと思うんですよね。
それは今日日本人、純粋な日本人でも結構多いとは思うんです。
ああ、はい、じゃあ、あんまり人種は関係ないと。
関係ないです。ただね、注意を促してるんではないかと思うんですけど、犯罪に染まらないように、早めに。
The police loved, especially in Tokyo, the police loved to come and bother me. I remember once when riding a bike, I was stopped 4 times in the same day. Each time they pulled me over, they said, ちょっといいですか? And they checked my ID, they checked my student ID. I was a student at the time. They ran the numbers on the bicycle to make sure that I didn't steal a bicycle. And then they let me go. I don't think that I would have been bothered by the police that much if I had looked Japanese.
何を基準にしているのかなってなると、やっぱその見た目なのかなって思ってしまいますよね。
見かけ上声をかけてるのか分かんないですけどね。僕は場所だと思ってない。このエリアは。
このエリア。
はい。
俺なんかだって六本木にいた時に1日俺4回職質食らったことあるし。
そうですか。
うん。やっぱそういう結局服装だったり髪型だったりするだけで、まあその時もともとヤクザやってたからね、俺。
あ、そうなんだ。
うん。
あ、本当ですか。
I've met Japanese police who clearly don't think that I belong in Japan.But none of them ever thought that I was a killer. And so none of them ever talked to me like they thought I was going to try to attack them.
I think it might depend on the culture they grew up with. So for example, making friends would be way easier for me if we similar culturally more than racially. But nowadays, I think less likely to see them differently more than I used to. Because many of them representing Japan like Miss Universe, athletes like Olympians. Yeah, for me, that's a big influence because I do watch sports a lot. I think it's kind of impossible to see someone representing Japan as a foreigner, right?
例えば大阪なおみやったら、別に日本に住んでたわけでもないから、ほんで日本語も喋れないでしょ。それで日本人代表って言われても、いや、それは違うだろうって。
ああ。そう。真剣にやって1位に争ってるとしたら自分がちょっとこうクソと思うことはあるかもしれないですけど、人種の壁ってやっぱあるじゃないですか。黒人さんの方がバネはいいですし、スポーツの面でももう圧倒的不利じゃないですか、僕ら白人アジア人。
長く育ってきたのは日本が多いので、もう気持ちは完全に和の心を持って生きてはいるんですけど、その絶対にハーフイコール英語が喋れるっていう偏見を持ってで、こう、接せられることは多いですね。
そういう根血の方が、なんか、すごい綺麗だったり、なんか、軽蔑とかないし。
Sometimes when I'm speaking Japanese, then they'll ask me if I'm half. But so I think, in general, I get treated more like a foreigner or like a tourist. The good part, I think, is that because I look so foreign, people will compliment me on my Japanese. They'll be like, oh, your Japanese is so good. But I also know that they're saying that from the perspective that they think I'm foreign. So if I looked Japanese, because I have friends who grew up abroad and they're, you know, they look Japanese and they are Japanese, but they didn't grow up in Japan. And if they make like a small mistake in Japanese, people are like, oh, why is your Japanese not so good? Even though they speak better Japanese than me.
まあ、ハーフの人ってその綺麗に見たらかっこいいとか、まあ、美人だとかそういう方多いんで、なんかそういう風にこうもてはやされるって言ったら変ですけど、こうやっぱチヤホヤされる存在ではあるのかなみたいな。
I had like the I want to be your friend because you're half. That was really shocking to me. And for me, I was like, that's really shallow.
そこはあの個人的には変わらないです。はい。まあ、いわゆる日本人の、なんていうんですかね、顔をしてなくても、日本人というのはもう今当たり前にいるので。
もう最近は、どこの国だからとかっていうのは全く意識しなくなりましたね。まあ、分ける必要があるのかもちょっと分かんなかったりとか。
今、そういう時代では本当はないですよね。ただやっぱり、あの、うちの下の息子も小学生なんですけど、あの、海外の方の子供さんもいっぱい小学校に来てますけど、子供たちの間では、なんか自分と違うと、髪の色が違う、髪の色が違う、肌の色が違うっていうので、子供って結構素直やけど残酷。
子供の子ってなんか誰かを、やっぱり誰かはいじめたり、からかったりしますもんね。うん、なんかそういうところじゃないところに行かせたいって思うのはわかります。
国籍とかその見た目とか、なんだろう、あそこまで関係ないのかなとは思います。あるところに結局いじめをする人はするの で結局日本人同士でもあるし、同じ外国人同士でもあるし、そこはもう全部消すっていうのは難しいのかなとは思いますね。
When, especially when they're fighting, will grab onto anything that they possibly can, whether it's race is something that they can see really quickly. Boy or girl, are you poor? Do you look a little bit differentAre your parents somehow different, etc., etc.? Is it racist if a kid calls you black? Is it more racist than if a kid calls you tall? I don't think that that's, necessarily clear. Man, to be honest, I sometimes have a hard time recognizing those things as racist. I caught all kinds of crap when I was a kid for being too dark from the white kids. I caught so much crap for being too light from the black kids. But for the most part,Realistically, I think they just didn't like me. I don't think it was, I think it was my skin color.
I have a friend in the States who were born here. He's a half Japanese, half American. When he comes here, people will look at him as a American. But when he lives in the States, people will look at him as Asian. He sometimes he feel like he doesn't have a home.So like, you know, like people look at him as Asian in America, but here, since he only speaks English, plus he's a halfer, people look at him as a foreigner, American.
Oh, what do you think? He looks more like Asian to you?
To me, he looked more of an American.
Oh, okay.
His face, yeah.
Oh.
But I can tell that, you know, people look at him as an Asian, like if you're in States, you know.
So treatment is kind of different.
Treatment is totally different in Japan and States, everywhere you go, I guess. Like, you know, they have their own problem.
People used to be more surprised when I started speaking Japanese in public, but now it doesn't really surprise people anymore. So I'm like, maybe my 雰囲気 is a little bit more Japanese than it used to be. Like, people aren't surprised, because before, people used to be really surprised. I would just go to the post office and ask for something and be like, oh. Or is it because, like, there are more foreigners in Japan now, so people are kind of getting used to it? Like, maybe it's both?
I have never been accused of being an optimist. But I really don't think that things will become anywhere near as bad in Japan as they currently are in the United States. I don't think we're going to see that type of division. Japan has this this cultural cohesiveness that the U.S. absolutely doesn't. They might be worse than they are now, and they might continue to get worse, but I think even at their worst, they're not going to be as bad as they are in the U.S.